Widows figure very prominently in two of our readings here today, and actually all throughout the scriptures, both the Old and New Testament, you will find widows that show up, and Jesus in the New Testament often uses them as an example of good and right living. And you might think, well, there's some sort of a special grace that applies to widows and their situation, or perhaps not. And kind of let me explain that. First of all, in our first reading, the widow is there with the prophet Elijah, and things are in dire straits in the land of Israel at this time. Because of their waywardness, their unfaithfulness, a famine and drought has they've been stricken with to try to bring them back to faithfulness. And Elijah is the prophet, and he needs to be sustained during this time of purification, really. So he calls upon this widow to give him some bread and some water, and then when she says, well, she doesn't have anything, well, make me a little cake, because the Lord says the flour jar will not go dry and the oil will not be used up in the jug. And so what does the widow do? She goes and does as the Lord said through the prophet Elijah, and is able to make the cake and is able to make the little loaves of bread that she, her son, and Elijah need to be sustained for a year, because she had trust in the Lord. And then the words of the Lord spoken to her through the prophet. The widow in the gospel, she gave her whole livelihood. She gave everything that she could give in putting just the two small, what were known as the mites, the widow's mite, and the little small coins that were worth really nothing, just a few pennies in our day. She puts them into the treasury alongside all of those people that gave in large sums, but large sums that were their surplus, that were not off the top. These were the things that they had kind of left over after they'd done all their other spending and such. And they just gave the rest to God. And it was a large sum, but from their heart, it really didn't amount to much at all. It was a few pennies to them. But for the widow, the few pennies were everything that she had. And her trust in the Lord, and trust that the Lord would provide for her and for her needs, was steadfast. And so she gave her whole livelihood. It reminded me of a widow that I celebrated a funeral mass for a couple years ago up in Shoreline. And I didn't have the opportunity to know her because during my time there, she was in her late 80s, she was in a facility, a memory care facility, because she had Alzheimer's. So I didn't get to know her in her prime. But when the time came for the celebration of the funeral, I had the opportunity to meet her five children and some of her grandchildren as well. And they spoke so beautifully about their mother and grandmother and all that she had done as a widow and a young widow. She was widowed at around 35 or 36 years old. Her husband died suddenly of a heart attack and left her with five children to raise. She didn't complete her schooling because she started to have kids, and she'd gone through a couple of years of school and was preparing to be a registered nurse. But all of a sudden, with her husband gone and no life insurance and getting the help and support of a little bit of from her family, she knew that she had to provide for her family. So she went back to school. She became a registered nurse and spent an entire career working at Harborview Medical Center as a nurse. And she was able to put her kids through St. Mark's School, and a couple of them went to Blanchette as well. And they told me about the beauty of her life and the beauty of how she lived her life as a very faithful Catholic, very devoted to the Lord. One of the things that they would do as a family was to pray the rosary at night together as a family. And she never wavered in that. She was a faithful widow, a good, good woman. She sacrificed a lot, as did the woman in the first reading. She sacrificed the flour that she had left. She was going to make that little cake for Elijah. And the woman at the treasury, she sacrificed everything. So trusting in the Lord and sacrifice are the part and parcels of the widows that we see in the scriptures. And we might say, well, that is a unique grace to them. But I would say that it is not. It's a grace that is open to each and every one of us, that we can have that same kind of faithfulness and trust as the widows did in the Holy Scriptures. And where do we get the ability to have that faith and trust? Well, of course, it is a gift of grace. And it comes from our baptism, which we are celebrating here at Mass today for little Veronica Jean here, who's going to be immersed into that grace. And by coming into the church, you know, we dip our hands in the holy water. We say grace before meals, and we're always making the sign of the cross all the time. And just like we did at the very beginning here, we signed Veronica Jean with the sign of the cross. And every time that we do that, we renew ourselves and we renew our baptismal promises that we have been baptized into the body of Christ, and we are in communion with each other and communion with God. And because of that, we can trust in the Lord for all things. We have the capacity to do that if we simply open our hearts to receive that amazing grace, really. But oftentimes, we don't do that until we are struck with adversity, until women become widows and men become widowers and the going gets tough. It is then, and oftentimes most profoundly then, that our sacramental grace kicks in so that we can draw close to the Lord when we need to, rather than going off to despair and confusion and depression and discouragement, which so much of the rest of the world does. But if our baptism really is true in us, if we cooperate with those promises that we made as little infants that were made on behalf by our parents on our behalf, and then as we grow into it, then we have the ability to draw close to the Lord when the going gets tough. And the grace and the sacrifice that we see the widows make in the scriptures, the same things that we can do when the going gets rough for us, whatever the challenge or the burden might happen to be for us. So today is an opportunity, as we witness baptism for Veronica Jean, for us to renew our baptismal promises, the grace and the power of divine life that's given to us in this sacrament that is at our disposal to use at all times in our life, but particularly when the going gets tough and the going gets rough. So we will all have an opportunity to renew our baptismal promises today. And when we do it, we need to respond with a robust, "I do," and really mean it from our hearts. Praise be Jesus Christ, now and forever. Amen.